Should do in such a situation. Even Japan, which had 54 reactors, has closed down all of them. And here we have a situation where the people are saying no, and the absolutely under military rule, the government is trying to start the reactor.
Absolutely. It is not only that Japan has stopped nuclear power plants, Germany has stopped power plants, America is closing down their power plants. Everywhere in the world, nuclear energy is being phased out. India is the one country in the world where we have not learned from Fukushima, we have not learned from Chernobyl, we refuse to recognize what happened, and because of the vested interests of politicians and scientists, the nuclear scientists, these projects are going on, and because people are not, generally in the country, people do not know enough about nuclear hazards, they are allowing it to happen. Luckily, the local people everywhere, wherever there are plants, whether it is in Jaitapur or in Kudankulam, people are resisting it with full energy. And right now, we are at the most critical point in time, because once the reactors are, the fuel is loaded, once the fuel is loaded, it is not reversible. In the sense that to clean it up again, it will take a major exercise and it will not be done without a cost, without a huge cost.
Why do you think, sir, that this government is getting so much
so this,
agitated
what I'm saying is
about...
This is the last chance to stop before huge damage is done.
Yeah. also to be seen in the larger context of the Indian government embarking upon the path of a nuclear energy expansion in this country, undermining the basic democracy, undermining the livelihood and safety of this people of this country. So we have come here today to release this statement. The same statement is being released today also in Mumbai and Kolkata. I would urge Vandanaji to say a few words.
I'm also here for solidarity with one of the most significant struggles for the future of democracy in India. I want to salute the people of Kudampulam who haven't given up in spite of all the terror attacks on them from what has become a militarized state. A very interesting new article has been published in The Economist, which is not a people's magazine, it's a corporate magazine. And The Economist says increasingly nuclear power will become less and less a creature of democracy. And that is why India's democratic fabric is being assaulted in order to impose nuclear power. The very agreement that has given license to spread nuclear was an undemocratic agreement that nearly killed our parliament, the US-India nuclear deal. And if it wasn't for purchase of votes, the cash for votes scandal, that agreement wouldn't have gone through. We then have the Civil Nuclear Liability Act, which underplays the costs of liability in case of an accident so that industry can walk away for free like they did after the Bhopal disaster. I believe Kudampulam is significant for many reasons. For some sad, perverse reason, our government is making a choice for the most backward, most primitive, most hazardous and most crude technologies in every sphere. Energy, we have so much more sophisticated alternatives from renewables, whether it's biomass, decentralized, Gandhi chose it, wind, solar, it wasn't there in his time. They're picking nuclear, which every country is giving up. Germany stopped it because their people said after Fukushima, we don't want nuclear. And nobody needs any more evidence that this is a dangerous technology than Fukushima. Aap sabne dekha hoga, Fukushima mein kaisa disaster hua. Germany stopped, Italy stopped, France will stop, the country that is highest nuclear power plant. It's going to stop under the new president called Hollande. Brazil has announced it won't go further. Japan has said no more. If every democratic, enlightened, technologically advanced country is saying no to nuclear, why is India picking this backward technology? In agriculture, they're picking the worst option. We have agroecology, we have organic, they're picking genetic engineering. And worse, when people with intelligence, information, freedom rise to educate the government about their rights and the rights to safety. I started my life in the Bhabha Atomic Research Institute. It used to be public sector then. It is no more. Everywhere nuclear is being shut down, we are giving them a red carpet. On our money, they've been imposing hazard zones. It's a double violation of democracy. Because it's our money that's being used to build these plants against our will. I really do believe that the assault on democracy that we are seeing in Kudampulam is something so serious that if we don't stop them here, they will do this on every issue everywhere. No citizen will be safe in their home, in their village, in their town. And that is why this appeal to all of you, not to government, to each of us, to raise our conscience, to wake ourselves up, to say this country got its freedom with a very long struggle that was non-violent. That is the path that the Kudampulam activists are following. That's the path we have a right and duty to continue following. And to the government, I want to say, don't send psychiatrists along with police. There's nothing wrong with the people who know about the hazards. If there is an insanity, it's at the level of Delhi. And if we need psychiatrists, let NIMHANS come and see why is the mind of the official India gone so berserk that they cannot make a single sane decision about the future of this country.
The bogus argument that nuclear energy is necessary for making India energy sufficient.
Yes.
It is the most bogus argument. I mean, it doesn't cut any ice on any facts and figures. And the second is that it is so unsafe that you are putting everybody in future danger which you cannot control.
Sure.
I mean, if Japan, which is the most safety-conscious nation, could not predict a tsunami and an earthquake together, tomorrow you can have tsunami, earthquake and atomic explosion together. How can you say that?
And if it can happen in Japan, Fukushima's can happen anywhere.